known as right layer. So right layer becomes continuously superior layer of coronary ligament. So this is a peritoneal fold which is reflecting from the diaphragm to posterior surface of right lobe of liver. What happens thereafter when the peritoneum is reflecting from the diaphragm to liver as superior layer of coronary ligament? First, it reflects like this. Then, this peritoneum will cover the anterior surface, superior surface. If you trace the peritoneum, peritoneum is a fixed structure. No? So, first it is reflecting to the diaphragm as superior layer of coronary ligament. Then, it follows downwards to cover the superior surface, to cover the anterior surface of the right lobe. It covers the right lateral surface. Then, it goes to the inferior border. Is it clear? So, from inferior border, this will reflect upwards. This is the position of kidney. So, from inferior border, it reflects upwards along the right end of the gallbladder. Okay? To the upper end of the right kidney. So, this reflection is known as inferior layer of coronary ligament. Is it clear? Lejara diaphragm theke elo liver e. So, that is superior layer. That peritoneum will go downwards to cover the superior surface, anterior surface and also to some extent right lateral surface. Then it goes to the inferior border. Now when it goes to the inferior border, from the right end of the gallbladder, it goes upwards to the upper end of the right kidney as inferior layer of coronary ligament. Now this inferior layer, when we trace it towards the left, right, it joins with the superior layer to form right triangular ligament. Okay? Now when we trace the inferior layer towards the left, what will happen? Tara gate jinish bole di just. Lesser sac. Now, if this is the stomach in a schematic sagittal diagram, this curvature is known as lesser curvature. And this surface is anterosuperior surface. And this surface is posteroinferior. So these two surfaces, they will be covered by peritoneum. So this layer is anterior layer of lesser omentum. And this layer is
posterior layer of lesser omentum.
So this is anterior layer. Okay? And this is posterior layer of lesser omentum. So one thing, this anterior layer of the lesser omentum and posterior, acha, what is this sac?
Lesser sac.
So one thing, this two folds of the lesser omentum, two layers of the lesser omentum, the posterior layer and anterior layer, they are coming from two different sacs of peritoneal cavity. As the existence of lesser sac is only behind the stomach. So rest of the part of the cavity is made up of
greater
sac. So posterior layer is coming from lesser sac. So this layer of the peritoneum is coming from which sac of the peritoneum?
Lesser sac.
Whereas anterior layer is coming from
greater sac.
Okay, this is the most important thing. Clear? Now in case of liver, the caudate lobe, this is the only area. This is the area for lesser sac, because this is the position of stomach. So this cavity is the area of lesser sac. Now in liver, the caudate lobe is the only area which is covered by peritoneum of lesser sac. Rest of the part will be covered by peritoneum of greater sac. What does it mean? It means that this falciform ligament, the superior layer of coronary ligament, inferior layer of coronary ligament, all are derived from greater sac. Okay? So only derivative of lesser sac is posterior layer of lesser omentum. Okay? Now lesser omentum in liver, it is L-shaped. Vertical limb is attached to this fissure for ligamentum venosum. Horizontal limb is around the porta hepatis. It is L-shaped. Now this is the left wall of the fissure for ligamenta venosa, and this is the
right
wall, which is nothing, which is anterior surface of caudate lobe. Now, and this one is the lesser omentum. Now, within this fold of, within this ligamentum venosum, fissure for ligamentum venosum,
the lesser omentum, it consists of both anterior layer and posterior layer. The lesser omentum fold term it will by means of forceps. So this omentum, it contains both the layers, anterior layer and posterior layer, but they are coming from different sac. Anterior layer from greater sac, posterior layer from lesser sac. So existence of the lesser sac only in this position. Okay? But rest of the part is greater sac. So falciform ligament is a peritoneal fold which is coming from which sac?
Greater sac.
Which diverges into two layer?
Right and left.
Right becomes continuous with superior layer. So that is also a part of greater sac, which covers the surfaces of the liver. And then from the right end of the gallbladder, it is reflecting upwards as inferior layer to upper surface of right kidney. So this inferior layer is also coming from which sac?
Greater sac.
Now these two layers, they join together from right triangular ligament. Now, if we trace the inferior layer towards the right, it forms right triangular ligament. If we trace the inferior layer towards the left, what will happen? Now this inferior layer, if we trace it towards the left, it covers the lower end of the vena cava group, but it does not invaginate into the group. Group is non-peritoneal because here lies the IVC. So the peritoneum cannot invaginate inside the group, but it passes along the lower end of the group. Then it goes upwards. It does not cover the portahepatis because portahepatis is non-peritoneal. The entry point is non-peritoneal, but the lips are peritoneal. Now this inferior layer from the lower end of the vena cava group, it goes upwards like this along the right margin of the caudate lobe. Okay? Then it ends at the upper margin of the caudate lobe. Is clear? Inferior layer, lower end of the vena cava group, right margin of the caudate lobe, and then it goes to the upper margin where it ends, inferior layer. Then come to this lesser omentum. It consists of both anterior layer
and
posterior layer. So both lie here. Okay? Posterior layer of the lesser omentum, it becomes continuous with this inferior layer of coronary ligament. After, ei jayga ta ki ligamenta menosame, this area is flowed and these are the two wall, left wall and right wall. Caudate lobe is the only area of the liver which is covered by peritoneum of lesser sac. Okay? Which wall of the caudate lobe will be covered by peritoneum of the lesser sac? This anterior surface. Which is nothing, which is the right wall of the fissure for ligamenta venosa. So this wall, one thing, right wall of the fissure for ligamentum venosum is covered by peritoneum of greater sac, lesser sac. Okay? Left wall of the, what about this left wall of the fissure? Now see, this peritoneum, when it covers these surfaces, anterior, right lateral, superior, one part is reflecting upwards as inferior layer. But another part will go towards the left, like this. And where from this peritoneum comes? Which sac?
Greater sac.
Okay, just it a remember. Now, if we trace the peritoneum upwards, it forms inferior layer. If we trace the peritoneum towards the left, it covers the gallbladder. Which surface? Lower surface, but it cannot invaginate in between gallbladder and the fossa. So that's why fossa becomes non-peritoneal. So if we trace this peritoneum towards the left, it covers the lower surface of the body, neck, and if it is fundus, then total, both surfaces of the fundus, anterior and posterior. But in case of body and the neck, only lower surface, not upper surface, because it is in contact with gallbladder fossa. Now, after covering the gallbladder, it will cover the quadrate lobe. Is it clear? Then comes this fissure. Now, within this fissure, there is already ligamentum teres hepatis. But these are the two walls, left wall, right wall, and this is left wall. What will do this peritoneum of the greater sac? It goes to cover, it will enter into this fissure. It will cover first the right wall, and then comes out to cover the left wall. But it cannot go to the floor because it is already occupied by teres hepatis. Tale byapar ta ki daralo dekh ami to shudhu ligamentum teres hepatis e jayga ta ache eta ligamentum teres hepatis. So peritoneum, it just covered this floor in wall, then it comes out like this. But it cannot goes into the floor, this floor, because it is occupied already by
ligamentum
peristalsis. So this walls will be covered by peritoneum.
So this peritoneum is coming from which sac?
Greater
sac. So this peritoneum, after covering the quadrant lobe, it will cover first which wall?
Right.
Then it comes
left.
Out
left.
As left wall. So one layer is invaginating, and this layer again comes out by covering the left wall. So like how many layers will get here?
Two
layers. One layer is incoming, another layer is outgoing. Outcoming, outgoing. So this is made up of two layers. So the ligamentum teres hepatis, this fissure, is covered by two layers of the peritoneum, and all the two layers are coming from which sac?
Greater
sac. Because there is no question of lesser sac here. Lesser sac only we get here. Yes. Now after covering the left wall, this peritoneum of the greater sac comes out. Then it covers this left lobe, inferior surface of the left lobe. Then it goes to the left wall of the fissure for ligamentum venosum. Clear? And it will cover the left wall of the fissure for ligamentum venosum. So this left wall of the fissure for ligamentum venosum, it is covered by peritoneum of which sac?
Greater
sac. So after covering the left wall, it goes into the floor, but floor is already occupied by ligamentum venosum. So it cannot cover the floor. Rather, it reflect from the floor. So it is entering, then it comes out as anterior layer of lesser omentum. Is it clear? This peritoneum of the greater sac, after covering the left wall of the ligamentum teres hepatis, it comes out and it covers the inferior surface of the left lobe. Then from the level of tuber omentale, when it comes closer to the ligamentum venosum, it enters into the ligamentum venosum. And it covers which wall?
Left wall.
Then after covering the left wall, it will be reflected outward as anterior layer of lesser omentum. Because here lies the stomach. And this will be the position of lesser curvature. This is the position of
greater
curvature. So this anterior layer of the lesser omentum, so it is coming from which sac?
Greater sac.
And will be reflected to the lesser curvature of the stomach.
Anterior
layer. Okay? Peritoneum of the lesser sac, only it covers the caudate lobe. Which surface of the caudate lobe?
Anterior surface.
Now this peritoneum of the lesser sac, after covering the anterior surface or right wall of the fissure for ligamentum venosum, it will be goes inside the fissure and reflected outward as posterior layer of lesser omentum. So in ligamentum venosum, we get four layers of peritoneum. What are those? Left wall of the fissure is covered by peritoneum of greater sac. This is one layer of peritoneum. Right wall of the fissure is covered by peritoneum of lesser sac. This is second layer of peritoneum. And itself is contains two layers of lesser omentum, anterior and posterior. So altogether, this fissure will be covered by four layers of peritoneum, and this fissure will be covered by two layers. Now what is the fate of posterior layer? This posterior layer, it becomes continuous at the upper margin of the caudate lobe with inferior layer of coronary ligament. তাহলে এই যে ইনফিরিয়ার লেয়ারটা গেছিল এইভাবে এটা এবার আপার বর্ডার অফ দ্য কডেট লোবে এটা কার সাথে কন্টিনিউয়াস হবে অ্যান্টিরিয়ার লেয়ারের সাথে কোনো কোয়েশ্চেন নেই বিকজ অ্যান্টিরিয়ার লেয়ার ইজ হিয়ার দিস এরিয়া উইল বি কভার্ড বাই পোস্টেরিয়ার লেয়ার সো তো পোস্টেরিয়ার লেয়ারের সাথে এটা কন্টিনিউয়াস তা হোয়াট হ্যাপেন্স দেয়ার আফটার দিস লেসার ওমেন্টাম দ্য টু লেয়ার্স দ্যাট লাই উইদিন দিস লেসার ফিশার ফর লিগামেন্টাম ভেনোসাম অ্যান্ড দিস ইজ দ্য ভার্টিক্যাল অ্যাটাচমেন্ট If we go to the horizontal attachment, anterior layer will cover the anterior lip.
Okay.
Anterior is also known as lower lip. Mm-hmm. And posterior layer will cover the posterior lip or upper lip. Now at the right end of the pota hepatis, at this position, this anterior layer and posterior layer, they join together to form the right free margin, which will be reflected to the duodenum.
Duodenum.
As here. Hepato-duodenal part of lesser omentum. So that is also known as right free margin. And within this, through this right free margin, the common hepatic artery, portal vein,
These are the structures that will enter into the liver through porta hepati. So this will be the position of common hepatic artery, portal vein and bile duct. And this will be the position of epiploic foramen. Okay, so these are the structures within the porta hepatis. So this is the portal vein. This largest one is portal vein. So this area will be the right free margin of lesser omentum. So ligamentum venosum is covered by 4 layers. Ligamentum teres hepatis is covered by 2 layers. And all the layers coming from greater sac. But in ligamentum venosum, we get both peritoneum, one coming from greater sac, one coming from lesser sac, plus 2 layers of lesser omentum. All together, 4 layers. So that is the peritoneal attachment. So after covering this L-shaped attachment of the liver, the lesser omentum will be reflected to the stomach up to lesser curvature. And within the lesser curvature, the layers again split to cover the respective surfaces of the stomach. So, caudate lobe, this area is very vital. So, that area is only covered by peritoneum of lesser sac. Okay. Next batch, I will discuss tomorrow.